I think if you spend a long time with any species in the wild, you are encountering the species as they truly are. And that allows for the understanding to be much, much greater. I describe it as wild wisdom, but that can only be acquired if you spend a lot of time with bees. I'm allergic to bee stings, so instead of being afraid of bees, I had to learn how to be with bees. We spend up to 8 hours a day, at least 5 days a week, with bees in the wild. We found out that we're the only people studying bees in this way. They're fascinating. Understanding that they're talking to one another, it's a mystery, trying to unpack what it is that they do and get up to. Globally, bee populations are crashing. It's a huge concern and many people know about it. There are many factors that contribute to that. Habitat loss, pesticides, the stresses that we put bees under. So to enhance our relationship with bees, we need to respect that they are wild and they have specific needs. One should understand what they do in the wild and try and mimic that. So the number one thing that has to change is how we house them. Square boxes are not healthy for bees. They're all these cold corners. There's fiberglass, there's plastic. The moment you use a synthetic material, the health starts to go wrong and the whole natural order starts to fragment. There are an amazing amount of traditional ways of keeping bees. Log hives, skep hives, tree beekeeping, those are beautiful homes. The world needs more habitats for bees. I don't often see beekeepers producing food for bees, planting, and planting enough forage for them all year round. I think the world needs wild spaces so the bees can be free to be wild, and those need to be protected as a number one priority. Bees should not be moved around from area to area. You need to get bees from your local area that are genetically sound, so they will live and know the conditions of your area and survive well. If you're wanting to have bees, you create the garden, the home, and see what comes. When we start mimicking nature's genius, we can definitely create sustainable farming practices that are healthy not only for bees, but for ourselves and for the environment. But we have to start looking at nature's genius to do that. My dream would be for people to start realizing that we have to free our thinking and our way of being on so many levels, from the production of food to how we keep bees, to our inner relationship with ourselves and our outer relationship with the world. And from that place, you are strengthened, and from that place, you are kinder, and from that place, you're a better person for yourself and for others.
All of you who have contributed, for those of you who've shared our films, for those of you who have written our comments, this journey is just beginning. And we've put a Patreon link below our films, so if you would like to continue to support us, we'd love for you to donate below. Thanks so much.